Well, good morning, everybody, to all of you, wherever you are in the world. We're live here at Potted Resort for the just 2020 World Indoor Bowls Championships. And coming up first match this morning is Paul Foster MBE against Mark Royal. And then later on today, we have at 1 o'clock, Stuart Anderson against Simon Skelton. And then the start of the ladies' semi-finals. Julie Forrest against Alison Merrion, MBE. And then this evening, Janice Gower against Nicole Rogers. And your match officials for today, your marker is Mike Davis. Umpire is Dan Blewett. And on the shot clock is Alan Thornhill. Well, coming up, as I've said, Paul Foster MBE, 5 times World Indoor Championships, and we go down now to Ben for the introductions.
Years and currently ranked number 14 in the world. Please welcome from England, Mark Royal. His opponent has 18 WT titles, a former 5 times World Open Singles Champion, and currently ranked number 3 in the world. Please welcome Paul Foster, MBE.
So we're all set for the start of another terrific day at Potter's. In the commentary box for us this morning, Sean Honor and David Corkill.
Good morning, Rishi. It's going to be another good game, another good day here at Potter's Leisure Resort. Mark Royal, left-hander. Very good player. Now at number 14 in the world. He's done well over the years, Mark. He's been around a long, long time. Good all-round player, Mark. Very good draw.
Like 24 and a half meters.
Wasn't well a few years ago, and he's come back very, very strong. The quiet man.
Yeah, he's a really nice guy, Mark. Works for Potter's now as well.
So he's a bit like a silent assassin, you know. He goes under the radar a little bit.
Yeah, he's very unassuming.
You know, the stars of the sport, and yet Mark Royal, for most of the players, has always had the most utmost respect because, to be truthful with you, he's incredibly dangerous.
Yeah, he's got a really good all-round game. And like you say, he just sort of works away at it, but he's never one to be discounted.
Lovely, easy action.
What a start.
Well, Paul's not one to shy away from attacking things, so. So if he goes.
Gap on the shot
ball
is half an inch, last ball is 2 inches.
Staying conservative, trying to make the target a little bit bigger. Well, he's very close with this.
Two green.
Oh, goodness me. One side of the rink, the other side of the rink for cover. Time for a little bit of wait. Third ball. Very close.
Good plant.
Yeah, played it well.
Yeah, played it really well. One gone.
Well, he's opened the door and he played that with very controlled weight. That's a confident shot.
Favour two green.
An opening end from Mark Royal.
I think there was a movie called that, Just in Time. On my memory, it's very good.
Was it before my time?
No. It's been within the last 3 or 4 years. It's
no.
Okay. And it was in colour. Trying to remember, Bill Nye, I think, was the star of it.
Just drifting past. Two shots to Mark Royal. Great end for both players, but particularly Mark.
Such a confident player on the draw shot.
On par, please. One green and a measure.
One green, measure for the second. Our rings indicated that it was the green just about, no more, very little in it. But Dan Blewett will sort it out for us. Good to see that, Dan Blewett, with the fingers across the top of the box measure, a little spring-loaded bit on the top. So you can see it there, a little circle, so he puts the fingers each side.
Two shots, Mark Royal.
Doesn't disturb the measure. Always good practice.
Track length 25 metres.
Asking a lot this time. Left hand though, on his forehand, so it should dip very strong at the end of its travel.
One red.
Still just a bit outside, not much though. That's good accurate stuff. I'm just wondering, will Mark be tempted with this a little bit? Trail of the Jack's really good.
Just drifting through again.
Yeah, I can see the way he was playing, it's very, very hard to pick out a line on that, so.
Very close, Paul, for a second.
Steeple Bumpstead Bowling Club, here again today. We're in the Cambridge area. Steeple Bumpstead, what a great name for a bowling club. Good effort by Paul,
yeah,
just
really
to
good effort.
Drift in.
On par, please.
One and a measure, I think.
It's good to see bowling clubs come en masse.
Yes, they do. Last week there was 53 here from my own indoor bowling club, Belfast.
One rest and a measure.
For 4 days.
Most of they fly over.
Yes,
Stansted. Most of the plane.
So trains, planes, and automobiles, that sort of stuff. There's a lot of people come over from all parts of the UK. I wonder what country that's from. There we go. The Scots are coming down in force.
One shot, Paul Foster.
As they should. It's arguably their most successful sport.
Set score 1-2.
Multiple
two,
world
two.
Champions, and they always do well at big events. One shot to Paul Foster. Good steady start from both players.
Jack length, 23 and a half metres.
Yes, well, the Belfast Club, as you know, it's a big club, and they put a tour on every year to come over here. Previous year was 40-something, this year it's 50-something, and no doubt it's gaining even more traction for next year.
It's good, because it's such a social break for people as well. There's a lot to do, as well as the bowls, and it's a nice little holiday, isn't it?
Absolutely. Had to ease off a little bit at some stage. So a new length. Yes, one of the attractions of this particular venue is the fact that it offers so much, but just getting to it.
I think people like the fact that everything's included. You know, you pay in it's bowls, accommodation, entertainment, food. It's all laid on for you.
One roll.
Using the green one. Paul one of the few players that uses a big long first step out. He's decided that going deep would be useful here in case Mark decides to hit it. I don't think he will.
No, I don't think he will. I think he's just be looking to draw inside his own. It's close to his last bolt. Good effort here.
One shot, Paul Foster.
Paul was just saying to himself, well, it's last ball. There's always a chance of Mark doing that.
The, three
the back ball goes in. He takes a single.
Track length, 23 and a half metres.
Good opening for Mark.
The mat's well up the rink, short jack length. Paul Foster normally very happy with the short jack length, but it's Mark Royal is getting in first.
Two green.
Just ramp up the pressure on Paul.
Absolutely. It's asking the question of whether he's going to play into this or draw it. He probably will still try and draw it, but if he's on the backhand, he's hitting it. Yep, he's going in the backhand, looking to get into something. It wasn't really that pretty in the backhand. He was trying to pump the front ball into the jack to move it. Took one out, but that should be replaced.
The percentages were there. He had the back bowls.
Oh,
that's a shame. That was an opportunity for Mark.
Yeah, it's a big clap on his hand. He realised he'd pushed through it.
Just pushed it
two
through.
Two shots, Mark Royal.
But a two nonetheless.
Set score 2-4 after four ends.
You'll notice that whenever that ball was coming through, Paul was kicking the balls back. Everybody knew it was two shots. And when these players know each other so well, there's no need to wait until the other player comes up unless it's close. They'll just move on with the game. There's absolute trust in that. Good sportsmanship and good to see as well. They're not messing about. Two pretty quick players. Paul Foster, one of the fastest on the tour, always has been.
At length, 24 and a half metres. Inches.
Mark Royal has only missed once in five ends with his first bowl. Strong pass in those bowls.
One green in the measure.
Yeah, that delivery is silky, isn't it?
Oh, it always has been. It's always been so good.
He's a lefty as well, so he'll be getting different lines.
Yes, he's on his backhand playing across the normal forehand line. But look at this from Paul Foster.
Okay.
it's quality stuff from both players.
Two red.
Very hard again.
And it comes.
Goodness.
Well played.
Oh.
Oh, what a ball.
Dear, dear. Tremendous stuff.
One green.
See, Paul Foster's chalked bowl's a toucher. That's another toucher. Either of them going to the ditch, they stay live. I think Paul's looking to see if the green ball on the red will remove the green one and move the jack. It might be worth playing this little tap on the ball just to move the jack. Yep. What he's looking for. Inside line, a little bit more aggressive than what I thought he might play, but this is going to bring it right out. Yep, there we go. One ball singles now.
One red.
Two options. Green ball on the red, on the green, or green ball full. He got the second one. He's going to have to go very wide with this.
Yeah, I wondered whether he might play the other hand, just under the red bowl.
Don't think it would stand up enough, and he's under the line because it was on his forehand, so it's always going to be pulling away from the high side. The ball will drift inside the jack. Paul Foster, he's right-handed, it's on his backhand, so he can play across the line in a different way. There he goes, standing right on the corner of the mat, that'll help. And what he's doing there is artificially helping the ball to stay up a bit longer. Hasn't gone too wide though,
no.
So this is all about weight.
Good enough.
Yeah, and it didn't drift as much either. He's always standing up. Just a technical point really for
one
players
shot,
if you're trying to play that type of shot. You can do it,
set
but you have
three,
to use
four,
the mat,
play
across the line. And then the ball doesn't drift back until nearly three quarters of its travel. Normally a bias takes effect at two thirds.
Well,
Jack length, 29 metres.
You see Paul Foster plays off the other side of the mat, the high side of the mat, with his draw balls almost all the time. And it's good because the one thing about that is that you have to push the ball out wide. And it'll always be coming back on the high side of the jack. Now, he hasn't pushed it for weight, but the line will always be coming back again.
Using the mat is something that perhaps the grassroots players wouldn't necessarily do, but it is there to be used.
Absolutely. It's something that I try and advise people on all the time, because it's a technical issue, but there's positions all over the mat that can affect how you play a ball.
One red. Two red.
Oh, still plenty of room to get around that.
So Lucy's first two balls Mark's had.
He's bending, needs an edge. Well, he got an edge and it wasn't thin enough, put it a little bit thick. It's a good second shot, but a thinner edge, you would have been very close to the jack. Quite appreciating the change of hand and getting a good close ball. Mark Royal is still there for him if he wants to play it, but his own ball sort of hampering him a little bit. He knows the ball will bend if he gets good weight.
He's on a flatter line. Just needs to stop in his ball. Okay. Just needed a little touch of the red to stop it.
Yes.
Really good ball. It must have looked horrible from the mat with his ball out of the side.
One shot, Mark Royal.
Set score 3-5 after 6.
Played it beautifully. What's really known now as an arriving draw, and that as a term really means, and there's that's about as much as you'll get from Mark Royal. A little fist bump, because it was a heck of a good ball.
It was a great ball.
And when I say an arriving draw, it means that you're guaranteeing the ball to arrive at the jack and with a little bit more weight than you maybe necessarily need.
Yeah, it's giving it a chance. That's probably what you call out to your teammate. Meters. Give it a chance down there, which means just with enough to get into the head.
Two
So, 5-3 to Mark Royal. Three ends to go. Two 9-end sets, of course, with a 3-end tiebreak if needed. Great game. High quality.
The drawing's been superb so far.
Yeah, some one or two running balls as well. I've been bang on target.
Look at this.
Oh, wow. Nothing to see.
Slight gap, about a quarter of an inch.
Well, all 16 seeds were through to the second round, but you can see why. Most years we get an upset somewhere along the line. Hasn't happened so far. Could argue with Alex Marshall going out. Six times world champion. No one would bet against him at any stage in the event. But he went out to Les Gillett, who was ranked number 5 in the world, so wasn't a shock. But then he did say he played probably the best game for many years and possibly even in his life in that match.
He was outstanding yesterday.
So
I don't think anyone could have... It would have been hard for anyone to take him on the form that he found yesterday.
You can't anticipate that. Sometimes it happens, sometimes it doesn't. And Foster will just try and drop a little bit here. Not much, though, because there's always a chance of getting his own ball onto the green one. Well, he's going for the little weight shot. Let's see how good.
Close.
Solid.
Oh, great ball.
Goodness me. Wow.
Great ball.
That is arguably the hardest shot to play in the portable rink.
One red.
What a ball. I thought he might have just played to try and turn the jag or get to the back green one, but Mark Royal sort of, he clapped that and a shake of his head.
Well, he got it perfectly. His front ball didn't move, just rocked it. And
all right, course.
Green ball goes.
Mark
one
has
shot's
four
cool.
timeouts remaining.
This is very close, David.
It is. He's going to drop, but not enough. Still one to red.
One red.
Well, Foster will probably play this on the forehand now, so he stays away from the jack. If he'd have drawn that on the jack, Paul Foster would have been thinking, what have I got to do? Oh, goodness, he's going on the backhand again. Well, that's... That's total and complete confidence if he's playing this on the backhand.
I suppose on the forehand, if he touched his bowl, he could turn the jack, couldn't he?
Well, he didn't want, he has to stay away from this jack, I can tell you. Look at that. Oh, then he gave a shot away and he looks at that and thinks, his facial reaction was enough for me. I think he really should have been on the forehand. Wow, that was nearly give a
Six
shot away. That would have been a disaster.
Seven.
Look at that. Oh, okay. Little grimace at the end as well. Yeah. And a smile. He's walking down thinking, maybe I should have played the forehand. Good stuff. Really good stuff.
Got away with it, one shot.
Yeah, Paul normally stays pretty stoic during matches, but
that length, 29 and a half.
Very happy out there, very relaxed. He knows he's in the game. One shot down, three ends to go. But both players are playing well. Well, he didn't look too happy about this one. Well, let's see where it finishes. And sometimes players can get it wrong. Yep, he knew he was just a little bit heavy. Most of us would be very happy with that as a starter bowl, but they do set their standards rather higher at this level. Oh, he's playing some bowls, isn't he? Needs to stay on the line a bit longer, run a bit, not quite.
On green.
Turning away very early.
He's gone quicker that time. Slightly better pace.
Well, some of the players have been telling me this forehand coming this direction for the right-hander.
In the front, it's 12 inches short of Jackie.
Mark Royal, he doesn't want to play it because he wants to play the hand that he's comfortable on, but it's very risky with that red ball there.
Yeah, it's right in his line.
So it might be easier just to go for position, go wider, and try and split the three red balls. Oh, he's played this well.
A good look. He needs to run. What an effort.
Yep, it's wondering. Not a bad place. The jack gets turned, it takes out the red ball. Well, Foster will look at this and think, is it worth playing the ball only? Possibly run the jack. He's got the back position. He's got the re-spot position as well.
It's definitely worth playing down there, bowl or jack. And he's been playing that controlled weight so well.
Oh, going away very fast.
Got the front green.
Well, that's another back ball for him.
Dipped quickly.
Mark Royal, not a lot of room, but if he was to play this absolutely perfect, he could drop the red ball out by falling back on it and make a three. But try and draw off the two, that's the target. Touching the jack would be a bonus. Make three then by doing that. He has to make sure of the double. Missed the chance. It's just too heavy, actually. He didn't really want to be that heavy.
One shot, Mark Royal.
Still a good position for Mark Royal. He's two in front into the last end.
Yep.
Set score 4-6 after eight ends. Thank you. Track length 25 and a half metres.
Great start.
I think he's missed two first balls in the whole set. They've been a couple of feet away.
And Paul stamped his feet on the last end because he knows that Mark has been starting like that and he missed an opportunity to get close with his opening ball.
Oh, this is good. First time.
One red.
See what both players are using in the bowls. It's Paul will be using the arrow. Looks like a groove where it's bending back. Fairly strong bias ball.
Too red.
He was thinking about going to a slightly straighter ball, but practice this morning probably confirmed that he needed something with a good band. Mark Royal using the Drake's Pride Professional, and they're very strong as well. They really are. They're coming back, so it's one of the swingy sets.
Timeout called. Mark has three timeouts remaining.
Actually bending more like an XP version. Some bowling, isn't it?
It's brilliant.
Oh, it's just absolute top quality stuff. Mark Royal probably have a pop at this, I would think, with weight. If he draws this, it would just be unbelievable. Yep, inside the line. A little bit of extra weight to try and disturb something.
Yeah, just looking to clear it. He's got the one red. Oh, yeah, good ball.
Didn't he play that well?
Yeah, good ball.
And the maximum result as well. He got exactly the right ball. Could easily have winged off his own front one, but he got enough of the red to disturb the jack. And Paul Foster will do well here to get anything out of the set. Might have to come around the short stuff, but this is interesting. Playing on the narrow side. Always going to be swinging away. I think he's working on the basis that it doesn't matter where he puts it, because Mark Royal will get closer than the front bowl. No matter where Mark Royal puts this, Paul Foster will be after it.
He's very close to the ditch.
Oh, he doesn't want to lose it. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Oh, that. Savage.
Well, that's really...
That's really harsh. After such a good ball of his third.
He's given Paul Foster about 5 or 6 yards to win the set. Dear, oh, dear. And that's where the left hand he was playing across the bias. He could have played his own forehand to play absolutely safe. And that is a disaster. And Paul Foster will be thinking, my goodness me, how on earth did that happen? He doesn't have to go anywhere near the ditch, really, at the side. He can just pop one in, take the three, win the set.
Three shots for a set, Paul Foster.
Wow, what a finish. What a finish.
Such a shame for Mark. He was in command of that the whole set. Played a really good bowl. And just that fraction outside. And he's got to pick himself up now and completely forget that and go into the second set. And how hard is that to do?
Yeah. And then Paul will commiserate with that, because I think they're just saying, when you watch this board, it looks like it's actually okay for a long time. It was going out very wide quite early, but there it just wasn't making it back.
No.
And, you know, you can see by the reaction he knows. He could have played the other side completely safe on his forehand.
Well, yeah, but you would expect... I mean, he just needed a second bowl.
He did.
Didn't he? And he could have gone as far under as... Yeah, he could have gone a couple of yards under and still had second bowl.
That length's 26 metres.
Well, these things happen, and it was a very, very good set, I have to say. Brilliant bowling from both players.
Yeah.
One shot either way. Even a drawn set probably would have been pretty close with the entertainment they've given us.
''12 inches short.
Service resumed.
8 inches. One in a measure.
Last
8 inches short. The gap.
What's going through his head right now?
Well, you know, he's been at this game so long that he knows, you know, things happen, and it was a mistake, and that's all there is to it. But it's been a very costly one. It's a game of two sets initially, two mini little battles to win the war. So we'll put it to the side.
One red. No, it's 7 inches short of Jack High.
Well, as soon as that Jack was pushed back by Mark Royal, Paul Foster would have been thinking to himself, well, the best I can do here is to get a half set.
Yep. Yeah, he wouldn't have anticipated a three
at all.
It
was gifted to him, and he took advantage, of course, because he had so much room.
One red. Yes, I favour the last ball second. Timeout court. Paul has 3 timeouts remaining.
Well, he's lying at the moment, we believe, one red. And he's just trying to work out, can he get around the short ball on the backhand? But it's easier on the forehand, but there's danger with the jack. He has to be very careful. Make sure he's slightly on the wide side, the high side of his own ball. Well, can I be Mark Royle here? I'll be taking that red ball away on his forehand.
Yep. Under Paul's last red.
See if he goes for it. Well, he's trying for it.
got to get down. It's wide.
He's not getting down. What's going to happen here? Oh, the run through. Not too much of a reaction there. And Mark Royal. It's just coming through. And the run through can never really be anticipated, but he did move the red ball, so it might be two.
Yeah, it's probably slightly favoured too, but it's close. That's very close. Yeah,
Paul Foster's now got a couple of options. He might run at this. Jack through's good.
Yeah, it's gone straight for the jack. It's high as well.
Needs help. He was staying away from his own ball just in case he got a really bad result and took it out.
Which he had to do.
Yeah. So he couldn't afford to be on the narrow side. But one on the measure. After controlling the head with a single shot for so long.
Umpire, please. One green and a measure.
Very, very close. Markers indicated a slight favour for green. You now see what the players or Paul's are using. That's a Groove S, yeah, that Paul's using. He spoke to me the other day. He was thinking about going to a different model after the pairs final. Thinking about going to a quantum bowl. Slightly different bias, but he's obviously happy enough to stick with the Groove.
He's playing very well with them.
And Blue will sort this out. Never assume anything in measures.
Two shots, Mark Royal.
Yep, one to green. It's just amazing how the experts can be proven wrong when you're looking at these things. Because
zero, two,
to be absolutely truthful with you, until the calibers come out, none of us can really tell.
Jack length, 25 metres.
One red.
Good stuff. Big crowd in for this match this morning. It was. It always looked like a really good game. Both players very popular. Paul Foster, five-time singles champion, and he's always going to pull a crowd in. But Mark Royal, well known in the area, well known here at Potters, so
very
a lot of support for him. Oh, look at this. Oh,
there's so many ends where it's just been changing bowl for bowl. It's brilliant. Great stuff.
One green.
Both players. players wearing the white shoes as required at the moment for this tournament. Next year, that will change to coloured shoes will be available in terms of you can wear them if you so desire. It's been discussed with the players and there's a big will there to change it to coloured shoes, which is the same in really all events around the world, you know, it's as long as they're manufacturer approved. Just drifting again. Oh, that's good grouping, isn't it?
Yeah, four good balls.
Wow. But only holding one shot. Paul has to be a little bit careful. He doesn't want to bounce this jack, so careful draw.
Effort this is. Oh, what a bow. Well played.
Absolutely nothing is safe in this match. Blue, white and ball, but nothing safe in this game.
One shot, Paul Foster. Set score 1-2 after 2 ends.
Inch or two away. No guarantee you're going to score. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant.
Track length 27.5 metres.
I can only think that I'm sure both players are very glad they're both playing well, because if one of them goes off form here, it'll be a disaster.
Yeah, the standard's so high that one loose end and the other one's going to capitalise.
On green. One green.
Great ball coming in.
Not sure if he's just sneaked in front or not.
One green.
Favour the green ball with it sitting down, and Mike Davies just confirmed that it's one to green. You won't want to touch that, so maybe wise to move to the other side. Yep.
Yeah.
truth of the rink is playing well. And just both players can move when they feel like it and get a good ball in.
Two green.
What does Paul do? Does he stay on the backhand?
Paul
He's
has
got his own bowl there.
I'm just thinking, how hard is it to take his own bowl out? The only way really is to get the green ball on the inside edge, coming away from it, and his own ball disappears. It's not going to cost him an extra shot, but the forehand draw is available. So there's a little bit of danger in the running ball. Absolutely no guarantees. He's going to play it anyway. All
very
about
close.
Connections.
All about what happens.
Well, that's not bad.
It wasn't the best connection.
No, but if he's line one, he's only going to lose one shot. He realised it was his own ball he was really after on that backhand on the high side.
Yeah, he got the green ball too full. He wanted the red one his own.
Paul's not concerned about that one. He knew that was going to be the number one.
Yeah.
Just a confirmation that it's just the one.
One shot, Mark Royal.
Mark wasting no time, but Paul just on that occasion waiting to get confirmation.
Set score 1-3 after three ends.
This game is moving along at a good pace, and players have got ultimate respect for each other. No messing about, looking at measures occasionally, but if they're not sure, they'll get the umpire out. But generally speaking, they're making a decision themselves.
Check length, 23 and a half metres.
This is the way we like to see the game played.
Yep.
First in this time, Paul Foster. Looking to add another. There's absolutely nothing is safe in this match, so he won't want to leave a shoulder for Mark Royal to use. Just about enough behind
one
to
red.
Make sure that won't happen.
One red.
6 inches away, and I think I heard one clap.
Yeah, they're very discerning, this crowd.
That's just so tough an audience when you're used to seeing top quality bowling like this.
Yeah, they expect it every bowl. And the players have been delivering, to be fair.
Well, that looks like that side of the rink is almost out of commission. It's still possible to get around it. But Mark Royal might have played that side where you can see the ball coming in on his forehand.
It's changed now.
I think there's more chance. You're the other side, you're crunching the jack in against the red. This one, you've got a chance to.
He's giving it a good shout.
Dip heavily into the red ball.
Paul Foster already started to clap. What a bow.
Well, you know, it looked like the right shot to play with the third ball, but he was forced into it with the last one that he played.
I think the angles just look nicer around that red ball. Just that touch shorter. Played it
too
perfectly,
green.
Though.
Oh, look at this.
Very close.
Oh, this is outrageous stuff. Oh, come on.
Brilliant, absolutely brilliant.
I think actually he's sitting just off the jack. I think it's maybe one to green.
And it looks like it's still one to green, but what an effort. He couldn't have played that any better.
Yep. One shot, Mark Royal.
One it is, ball's kicked back. What a fantastic play. See the ball just crunching the jack.
Set score 1-4 after four ends.
And then it fell back a little bit. It's been a long time since I've seen two players playing at this level in the second round of a tournament. They're just unbelievably good.
Track length 26 and a half metres.
Well, we've seen some great individual performances, but...
Yeah, that's the difference. They've both been at the same standard in this game.
That's the loosest first two balls I can remember with Mark Royal. He can't keep doing it every end, though.
Ball wasn't happy out of his hand with this ball.
That means it's usually a bit on the heavy side. Don't think he's that bad, to be honest with you.
I'd probably take that.
I just think I'd take that all day
long. Yeah, too red.
That surprised him a little bit. But he knows the way this man's playing, it's beatable.
Very good effort.
Yeah.
Well played, Mark Royal.
Sort of expected it to happen though. And that's the problem. The expectations now are so high.
Indicated. Yes, it's 1.5 inches past.
Stand up long enough to get the ball of the jack.
Well, it's got the jack.
Oh, well, there's a green ball there, but it's still opened it up. He wanted the ball solid, not the jack. But nothing staying.
One red.
Well, we talk a lot about building the head and stuff like that, with opportunity to build heads up and put your opponent in trouble, but everything's changing with the next ball. He's going to play exceptionally well yesterday to beat Alex Marshall, but this is frightening. Both players.
Yeah, both players.
Ball playing across for the ball or the jack. Wants to guarantee it with the ball though. He's got the jack. No, is it going on the re-spot or is it staying in the ditch? If it goes onto the re-spot,
two down.
He'd be
shaking
two down.
His head.
No,
it looks.
It's very close.
It looks in from this angle, but.
One shot, Paul Foster.
Oh, yeah, it's just yeah. In. Oh, it was right on the marker.
He
you
wasn't
can see
sure,
it there.
Was he? It was shaking his head.
Wow. And that would have been very,
Seth's
very difficult
two, five.
If that jack had a
bar. Sorry, 2-4 after five ends.
Mark Royal would have scored two.
Yeah, that's a key moment in the set. To pick up one. Great end of bowls. Oh.
Fantastic. The fact that he got the target was exceptionally good, but he kept it in the rink.
Check length 29 metres.
Foster went much longer with the jack, which you would expect, just trying to change something, but front toucher from Mark for his first bowl.
He's turned his back a little bit on this. I think he might feel he's overcorrected. Let's just see how far it gets back in again. It's not that far away. Well, I don't know if he turned his back there because he wasn't sure, but that's a brilliant goal again from Paul Foster.
One red.
Struggling with this one, just not reaching, but it's not going to help Mark Royal
the gap on shot
sitting in that position.
1.5 inches.
No, that makes it awkward.
I That's why there's a slight hesitation. He might take a time out here. Yeah, thought he might. He needs to come up and look at this.
Timeout called.
What he's looking at is just the angles to, can he get around the short ball? The forehand's not very clever. You know, the angles he's looking to come in here onto the ball on that side. Now he has to shave the red ball. The other side, well, he has to come around the green one. Neither of these options are very appetizing, but you just have to play it one side or the other. He's had a good look. Oh, he's going for it. I'm very surprised at this
I'm
shot.
Not at all. I think that looked horrible to draw. He's very close.
Take his own out. Yeah, that's why I didn't like it. And I don't know why I shocked at that, because at 4-2 up and you're one shot down with a good second and Paul's dropped short. Now he hasn't got a ball anywhere near it. And there's two or three against him.
Well, now he's forced to draw second, obviously, but yeah. I'm not too surprised red. He played it.
Well, I wouldn't have been anywhere near that shot. I really wouldn't. It just was fraught with danger and... well, onwards and upwards, as they say. He's played it, he's taken his own out. Paul Foster will pop another one in.
Three red.
Now he has to draw. He's got enough room to draw for second shot. He gets a shot, it'll be a fantastic ball, which the way they've been playing is possible.
Good ball, Mark.
As expected, he got very close. Paul would have expected that as well.
One shot, Paul Foster.
Set score 3-4 after 6 ends.
Good crowd here, as expected. And there we go. A little elbow saying, smile please. Mm-hmm. That's the Bedford Borough Bowls Club. Not the BBC, but
she's
the
saying,
BBC.
Don't look at the camera.
Very nice too. Nice
28 and a half metres.
Look well. As opposed to my own club, the outdoor, which is Belmont Bowling Club.
It's just becoming more and more colour with all the club kit now, which is really good to see.
Oh, there's very few clubs now just playing plain white. And that's old school.
A lot of the clubs now are having coloured trousers and shorts as well, which just adds another dimension to the uniform. I'm all for it.
Absolutely. I must admit I am too, especially even the tracksuits look well.
Yeah, they do, and the hoodies are smart too.
As long as it's all uniform, as opposed to all different. There's a club identity.
And if it becomes more attractive to people that are, you know, switching in or walking past a club and seeing bowlers, then it's got to be good, hasn't it?
Yes, and the young people as well. Shake the head. He was just trying to get close with that and he's dropped through 2 feet, but.
One red. Your last ball, just under 3 feet. Two red.
Unusually, there's plenty of room to draw the shot. Just doesn't happen in this match. Mark Royal pushed it out wide, as the case with these balls are
better here.
Big enough balls to come back.
Well played.
One green.
Sure about this one. He might be a bit on the pacey side.
It's just going to hang.
Well, he's in trouble now. Seventh end so crucial in the 9-end set. Player behind has to really score. Losing one, well, you're within kicking distance in the last two ends, but if you lose two, you have to chase it.
He's
good.
Yeah, he's good enough.
Two shots, Mark Royal.
That was a good spare shot because it was very important that three shots now gives him a little bit of a cushion. Paul Foster, of course, only needs to draw the set. He doesn't have to win it. So he's looking for three shots in the next two ends.
At length, 23 and a half metres.
Misses with a second one.
It's very good. This is a crucial end for both players.
Oh, look at this.
Great ball. Great ball.
Oh, dear me. That's just outstanding stuff.
I'm not sure Paul's looked that comfortable the last few ends, but he's still bowling such high quality bowls.
At 1.5 inches past.
He's not going to make it any easier. Royal. I'm just trying to draw the jack here. Pick his hand. Yes, it's very warm out there, very hot. Neither of these players are using shorts, but ultimately, this is what they're looking for. The trophy, Langham Glass. Paul Foster's lifted five times. Over. Well, Paul Foster's done what he has to do, and that is score the shot this end. If he can get another, which would not be easy, but it would be very handy.
Yeah, he put himself in a really good position for the last end.
He's interested.
Oh, that's good.
That's
good.
Oh,
okay.
Goodness me. That was not an easy spare shot, but it was an important one.
Two shots, Paul Foster.
Oh, both players.
Set score 5-6 after 8-10.
So well. It's classy, it's entertaining, it's quick, and it's had all the thrills of one of the best matches I've ever seen. Paul Foster and Matt well up the rink.
At length, 23 and a half metres.
Half a metre beyond the minimum, 23 and a half metres. One shot required by Paul Foster. So it's really a one-end shootout. One wins the match. The other one thinks of it as an opportunity to win the match in the tiebreak.
One red.
It's a decent ball, but Paul Foster knows it's not close enough.
Up. Get up.
And he's calling for it to get up. I think it's going to make it for shot.
That's good enough for shot. Sure.
On green.
Well, it's a bit low on the line side. Yep, he is low. As it turned out, actually, it was just pace more than anything. He's bang on centre line, so... Just didn't reach
12
it.
12 inches past Jack High.
He's going to leave it to his last ball here. Mark Roy will be thinking, get one really close. I'll be into a tie break. Oh, wow. Hear me. I fully expected that to be within 3 or 4 inches. Ball taking his time.
Yeah, pressure's on him.
Yep. Usual outside of the mat, coming off the high line. He'll be wider than his last one.
He's not.
Well, in that case, his weight has to be very good. How close is he going to get? And okay. The answer to that is very close. That's what he was looking for. Not only the shot, but he's also got a second shot. Which means Mark Royal cannot just take the bowl out. He has to take both bowls out.
It's very close, but I think you might just have second, but it's very close, Mike.
Well, they're saying it's very close, actually, for the second shot. And that's crucial.
Yeah, you've got one left.
Mike Davies having a good look at it. They're very accurate, these officials.
One red.
It's not the time you want to get it wrong, is it?
Well, he's called it as one red, which means Mark Royal can flick the ball out, so he'll play this with controlled weight, allow the ball to bend just a little bit. That's what he's trying for, and he's in the area.
Oh, just the edge.
Just the edge. Oh, he's hit his other green ball. I don't believe it. He's moved the other green ball. I don't think he's realised it. But I think that's going to make all the difference in the world.
Just rocked the back green ball on its way through.
Measure for shot.
It's a great bow. He's unlucky to catch that bow as well, Corky.
Absolutely. And if this measure goes against him, well, that's just very unfortunate. Clean ball, he was good, but that rock could easily have moved at a quarter of an inch. Dan Blewett will sort it out for us. And we have a very good view. Well.
It's one green.
One looks shot. Like it's still in the green. Now, that would have been cruel, to be honest with you.
That
really would have been.
Very, very harsh. And I think it's right this game's gone to a tie break.
Oh, absolutely.
It's, you know, especially the way the first set ended for
Mark. Won the toss and give the jack to Mark on the
so
first
well.
End.
Yeah,
fantastic last ball by Mark Royal and Paul Foster.
Yeah, great, great ball by Paul. And cracking takeout by Mark. Played it absolutely perfectly.
I don't think anybody will be leaving the arena. This is just too good.
It's buzzing in there.
Jack length, 25 metres.
David Gurley's keeping an eye on things. He's probably actually just checking on his stocks and shares and property portfolio and all those other things that he has. You'll be watching this match. David Gurley was exceptional in his last match against Michael Stepney. Another player who's in top form. And we'll be keeping an eye on this. So, 3-end tiebreak. Just a matter of winning the end. No accumulated shots. And of course, when we get to the third end of a tiebreak, if required, things change again, and I'll explain that when we get to that point.
One green.
Well, mistake by both players with their second bowl. But the position of the head is very much favouring Mark Royal.
If he can just tidy it up with this bowl, really, really put the pressure back on Paul.
Well, he's just a little bit through, still a chance.
Has he got the pace?
I think it's struggling.
One. Yeah, Mark's got two. You've got two left, Mark.
Just checking about timeout, so a little trot up the green. Plenty of time. Is it 19? Yep, or 18 seconds, so plenty of time to get this ball away.
Position to finish in. Makes it really hard for Paul.
It does. I'm looking at different angles and things to hit in, and there's just nothing there. And I think that's why Paul walked away.
Yeah.
Well, the front balls.
Yeah, he knew.
All the plants are going the wrong direction, so he's going to have to try and draw within 2 inches. Drop back.
Great effort.
Oh, he's just an inch
Great
away.
Effort.
He's 3 inches away.
First down, Mark Royal.
Won the green.
Track length, 25 metres.
Right, I've been loving this game.
Well, they've just been treated to such a great game of bowls, as have we. Good opener here.
Both players' draw shots have been exceptional.
2 inches.
In a tie break, it's all about getting into the head, and that's a front ball toucher, which if it travels in with the jack into the ditch. So Paul Foster's aware of that. He wants to get the edge of it. He doesn't want to get it full. But he played it well.
Played it really well.
Got half ball and travelled in himself. Close to the ditch, and the toucher will stay live, but it's well away. Yeah, he played that really well. Aware of the danger. So it's all about who can get closest to the edge of the ditch now.
What a bowl that is.
Bearing in mind,
Paul's got the option to take it clean off.
Well, he already has lost one ball at the side ditch. That was a very good goal from Mark Royal. And Paul's interested in this, he's watching it. Oh, he's got it. Oh, well played, Fuzzy. What a ball.
Brilliant, absolutely brilliant.
Mark, can you do it again?
You've got to put it back, Mark.
You fully expect him to. It's never easy repeating a ball of that quality.
It's on exactly the same line.
It might even be a shade wider, which is good. Is he up and up? I think he might be. Looks like he might be.
Just sat down.
Yes. Last ball.
Last ball.
It's,
Paul, can you do it again?
Just over about 2.5 feet, the gap.
I'm not sure if he'll go again or really he'll draw. Oh, he's on the inside of the mat. He's going for it.
He's got to go again.
Yep, he's going for it. Is he getting down to it?
He's not reacting.
Oh, I think he knew he was just slightly wrong.
He didn't react.
What a match. What a game of goals. Absolutely and truly unbelievable. Everything about that was good. Every single end was good. And the crowd reacting to Mark Royal on their feet.
Yeah, it was a brilliant game. Mark really held his nerve and he drew so well throughout the whole match.
Oh, absolutely. Now, normally that's left to a final when people are on their feet when in a match like that, but second round and Mark Royal gets a standing ovation for just pure quality. They're all coming down to say hello and to congratulate him. And you know, but your heart goes out to Paul Foster as well. Like, and against any other player in this tournament, the way they've been playing, Paul Foster, you know, would have been the man.
Definitely. He played some fantastic bowls. Drawing and running bowls. His running bowls today were brilliant, Paul's.
What a game. Well, we couldn't ask for anything better, and it's going to be very, very hard to get a better match than that. You know, Paul Foster, as I say, anybody playing less than Mark Royal did today, and he would have won that match comfortably. But he knew he was in for a tough one. Mark Royal's a top-class player. But Paul Foster was doing everything. Good, accurate running balls, cutting shots down, damage limitation. But Mark Royal was just superb in his drawing. He really was outstanding. And then, of course, in the first set, he lost the ball on the side ditch. Most unusual, but it cost him the set. But it was brilliant bowling by both players. And nothing was safe. Anything that was within an inch or two could be beaten. Paul Foster showing again his skill of adding another shot. That was vital in that particular end. And that bowl out when Paul Foster was lying, well, that was just unbelievable. Such accuracy, such brilliant bowling. Ends 1-11-9, shots scored 12-13. Well, that comes down to the tiebreak, of course. Touchers almost even. It was one of the best matches I've ever seen on the portable rink, and I have to say, thoroughly enjoyable.
Absolutely. One of the best matches that we've ever seen here at Potters. One of the best matches ever seen on the portable rink. An outstanding match between Paul Foster and Mark Royal. Paul, I know it's probably no consolation having lost, but I can't imagine you've played better in defeat.
It's a sore one to take. First and foremost, well done to Mark. I thought he played an exceptional game. There was nothing in it the whole match, but first of all, good luck in the quarterfinal, Mark. Well played, pal.
Thank you, cheers.
I was delighted how I played throughout the whole match. Yeah. I think to win the first set was possibly an injustice. Because Mark, I didn't think Mark Foe was going to the side ditch. I just wish he'd maybe put some more in the side ditch. But anyway, I took advantage of the set. And the second set, although it was 4-1 down, there was never that in it. And to draw two for 6-5, and to be honest, I thought I had it at the last end because that's one of the hardest shots to play with, yeah, what we call silly weight. And but he got it perfect. I just had to hope. I was hoping he'd miss it, obviously, but yeah, maybe get the ball into Jack. But he played a brilliant pressure ball at the right time. And I always say big bowls wins matches, and Mark did it. And I was unlucky at the second tie break end and the first one as well, but Mark put a cracking shot in. And yeah. As I say, disappointed, yes, but pleased to have played, and I just wish Mark all the best.
Thank you. Cheers.
Well, Paul Foster definitely played his part in this match. Mark, if you don't mind going back to the end of the first set.
Really? Do I have to?
And just tell me your thoughts at that point.
At the end of the day, I was trying to defend a two. I put two bowls within a few inches, and Paul drew his first two in. We mustn't forget that at the start of the end. Yeah. And I hit my runner.
Yeah.
So I had three pretty good bowls, to be fair.
Yeah.
And then I should have practiced this jack on the spot. So I haven't practiced that all week. I've been too busy working, but there we are. So I need to practice that a bit. But I could have fallen apart then, to be fair. I think a lot of people would. I held myself together. Kept thinking of my mate Martin Heitzman. Yes, mate. Keep saying yes, mate. And yeah, it was a great game. Paul, we both played really well, and it could have gone either way. To be fair, the crowd were amazing. When I chipped Paul's bowl out, I actually did touch my own, and I thought I might have rocked it away.
Yeah.
And I couldn't look at that one, to be fair. And luckily, he got away. But it was a great match. When I came on, the announcer said the results to Paul was 3-2 in wins to Paul. I'd say it was more like 8-1 to Paul, to be fair, over the years. So they were right on the two, because I've won two now.
Well, you most certainly have won today after the most incredible match, and I think everybody here at Potter's enjoyed it.
Well, there we are. What a superb match. And what we've got coming up for you later today is 1 o'clock. It is Stuart Anderson against Simon Skelton in the next singles match. And then this afternoon, Julie Forrest against Alison Merrion in the first of the ladies' match play semi-finals. And then 7:30 tonight, Janice Gower against Nicole Rogers in the remaining semi-final. Well, ladies and gentlemen and viewers, hope you've enjoyed it. We're going now. See you back later. Be here. Bye-bye for now.